What's up, y'all? I'm DJ Premier, and I present to you So What's Up.
Okay, computer. Run it back.
So What's Up. Oh, man. I've done this interview many a times about this song, but add a little twist on it. Song I'm talking about? Mass Appeal. This floppy disk is so hot that I don't even want to hold it. It's one of the biggest parts of my career. Shout out to Mass Appeal, the magazine, who said that they were inspired to call their magazine Mass Appeal because of us. We even did a limited edition Mass Appeal Gang Starr run with them when they relaunched their magazine. So shout out to Peter Bittenbender, shout out to Nas and everybody part of that clique. This thing is a very valuable piece right here. It's an heirloom. What made it special for me is because when we were creating our albums from Step in the Arena moving forward, Guru would always write out every title of the song and stick it on the wall. And we would just look at it in no particular order. And he would have little descriptions of what it was. Code of the Streets might be about, you know, car theft in our city. Got it. Tons of guns. About all the guns going on in the world and how people are getting killed left and right from just mishandling of guns, you know. Mostly The Voice, which is about how your voice is one of the key things that make you dope. No matter how good you write, a lyricist, performer, it's your voice that makes you special. I don't like my voice, but a lot of people say they love it, so I utilize it. But moving forward, Mass Appeal said our first single. Every time we work on an album, we don't do the singles until everything else is done. That's always been our way, and we always stuck to it. Because we want the singles to be fresh out the oven, straight to your ears. Let it play, let it jam. So,
same thing.
Mass Appeal was that same decision, but the only difference was Guru really wanted to have a radio hit that still sounded like it repped the streets, but still repped
mainstream
or just airplay on, you know, regular stations that play rap. First of all, shout to EPMD, the legends. They had a song called You're a Customer. It was the first 12-inch single that they dropped. And back in those days, in the 80s, late 80s, girl, going into the 90s, B-side or the A-side, after you have the main version, would sometimes have an instrumental or what they call a dub. A dub version was on the 12-inch where there might be things just taken out and just words injected. So it might go, Nick, Nat, Pat, don't stop. It's not all the words, just little pieces. And that also is a part of how, you know, the history of dubs and things of that nature were made with a lot of reggae artists, and it transferred into hip hop, which they're all affiliated anyway.
So
I've always been into my drums and different places where I take them and re-manipulate them and flip them. So the dub version, being that I am a DJ and we played in the parties, I always wanted to flip that drum because of the way that it just, I never heard the way it was flipped like that with their pattern. So what I did was, when I found the sample to Mass Appeal and started finding ways to manipulate it to make it work for us, I said, you know what? The sample starts after the four count. You know, one, two, three, four.
Now, the drum doesn't start at that same spot. So I said, I've got to let the drum start at the four. So instead of going bump, two, three, four, it goes one, two, three, four, bump, 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 like that. That little bump up is what starts the song, because if you put on Mass Appeal, it goes bump, 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 bump. It just doesn't just start on and go bump, bump, bump. It goes bump, bump, bump. So that bump, bump, I said, something's got to make it
really, really catch. And I said, let me look for scratches. Shout out to the youngsters. Shout out to the P-Rock remix. I remember when I heard that once again, I revealed the skill. I said, if I started with money on the bump up, it's going to make the record jump. And that's exactly what it did. So when you load that disc in and then get the record at the top, DJs know how to catch it.
Some DJs don't, but if you're a true hip hop DJ, you know how to catch it.
And then it said one,
two, three, and. And man, we didn't know if it was going to be a hit or not. It was one of our first radio records that we've ever had in our career. And it is still one of the biggest records. When I play it out live or just anytime we perform it, it tears the city down, tears the club down, tears any venue down, anywhere you go. If you're driving in the car, if you're in your earbuds, however you're listening to it, Mass Appeal does it like that. And because of that, it's one of the most special records of our career, and it made Hard to Earn do very well for us when we released it in 1994. And again, man, you gotta respect the floppy disk. It's a banger right here.
One for the treble, two for the steel. Yo, Premier, tell him how we feel.
Once again, I reveal the steel. Money's so when I grab
the steel. Yeah, yeah. The mother. We gonna do this East New York style. We normally do it. Brooklyn in the house.
Yeah.
Word to mother. Yo, son, how we